Hello friends, now we are going to study the medium transmission line nominal pi network. So what we are going to do is we are going to divide the admittance into two parts. This is Z. And this is admittance. Admittance means y by 2 and y by 2. This is y by 2 and this is y by 2. So this is our receiving end. This is our receiving end RL load. This is our receiving end RL load. This is our receiving end RL load. And this is sending end. So sending end voltage is Vs and Is, and receiving end voltage is Vr and Ir. Vr and Ir. So this is Vr and Ir, this is RL load. And now what we can see here, now we are going to find out the ABCD parameter for this network first. So while finding out the ABCD parameter for this network, we can divide this in three parts. We can divide in three parts like Vs, Is, and we can calculate the final relation between Vs, Is and Vr into Ir through cascading network. So 1, 0, y by 2 and 1. This is first matrix. Second matrix is 1, z, 0, 1. This is second matrix. And now the third matrix will be 1, 0, y by 2 and 1. So this is Vr and Ir. So this is Vr and Ir. So when we will multiply these two matrices, this will become Vs, Is and is equal to 1 plus Yz by 2, 1 plus Yz by 2, and this is Z and this is Y, and this is 1 plus Yz by 4, and this is 1 plus Yz by 2. This is 1 plus Yz by 2. And this we can write Vr into Ir. This we can write Vr and Ir. So right now we can see from here, we can write from here basically Vs Is is equal to 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 1 plus Yz, 1 plus Yz by 2 Z Y, 1 plus Yz by 4, Yz by 4, and 1 plus Yz by 2, and in the same way Vr, Ir, Vr, Ir. So this is the condition. Now what we can see is A, B, C, and D. So ABCD parameter are given. So A value is coming out to be, A is value is 1 plus Yz by 2, and value of B is Z. Value of B is Z. So the value of Z is equal to B. So we can write A minus 1 upon Z is equal to Y by 2. So Y by 2 we can replace A minus 1 upon B. So when we draw the nominal pi network in terms of ABCD network, we can write A minus 1 by B, A minus 1 by B, A minus 1 by B, and this will be Z, this will be Z, this will be Z, and this will be A minus 1 by B. This will be A minus 1 by B, A minus 1 by B. So this is the overall nominal pi network. This is the overall nominal pi network. So now this is the ABCD parameter, and now we are going to draw the phasor diagram for this circuit. So while drawing the phasor diagram, we can write the voltage equation, that is Vs will be equal to, this Vs will be equal to this Vr, this voltage is Vr. So Vr plus, let us assume this is a ITL, this is not Is, this is not Ir. So Vr plus ITL into Z. So Vs is equal to Vr plus ITL into Z. So what we can do is, we can calculate this ICR. ICR and this is ICS. So we can calculate first ICR, and the ICR value will be equal to, ICR value will be equal to VR into Y by 2. And the value of then VS we can calculate, that is VR plus ITL into Z. So ITL means from here we can write VR plus ITL is equal to nothing but IR plus ICR, ICR into Z, VS. So ITL I am writing differently. ITL is equal to nothing but IR plus ICR. ITL is equal to IR plus ICR, IR plus ICR. So this is ITL is equal to IR plus ICR, and IS value, we know that IS value will be equal to ITL plus ICS, ICS. So now we are going to draw the phasor diagram. So first of all, we will draw the load. This is VR. This is VR. We know that this is VR and this is IR, and the current is lagging voltage by an angle of phi R. Current is lagging angle of phi R basically. So here this angle is phi R and this is VR. So this is the load has been given. So now first we will calculate ITL. But before ITL, ITL we know that ITL is equal to IR plus ICR. So first we have to calculate the value of ICR. ICR is perpendicular to VR because this is the capacitor. So this will be the 90 degree. This will be the 90 degree from here. That is this. So this is nothing but our ICR. This is ICR. So ICR angle is 90 degree. And now we can see this is IR. So IR plus ICR, IR plus ICR basically, IR plus ICR, IR plus ICR basically will be equal to IR plus ICR will be equal to ITL. So this will be equal to ITL. This will be equal to ITL, ITL. So if you want to calculate the VS, then VS we can simply calculate VR plus ITL into Z. So VR plus ITL into R. So this will be ITL into R, and this will be ITL into, this will be ITL into XL. So this will become, this will become VS simply. So this is simply VS, this is simply VS. And now IS we have to calculate. So for calculating the value of IS, we know that IS is equal to ITL plus ICS, but ICS value we don't have idea, but we have the idea of VS, and ICS will be perpendicular to this VS because this is capacitor and the voltage across this Y by 2 is VS. So what we can do is we can simply draw this 90 degree, this 90 degree from here. That is, this will be ICS, that will be this IC S. And now we can see if you want to calculate the value of IS, then ITL plus ICS, ITL plus ICS, this is ICS, and this will be equal to IS, this will be equal to IS. Now the angle difference between VS and IS will be equal to phi S. So this is all about the phasor diagram of medium transmission line. And what will be the power loss in the system? What will the power loss? Power loss will be equal to 3 into ITL square into R. So this is all about medium transmission line. Thank you.